Eric DeBay is a basic liar who has the ability to suck people in with his bullshit. We'll listen to some of that bullshit right now.
44. If Earth was a ball and Antarctica was too cold to fly over, the only logical way to fly from Sydney to Santiago would be a straight shot over the Pacific, staying in the southern hemisphere the entire way. Refueling could be done in New Zealand or other southern hemisphere destinations along the way, if absolutely necessary. In actual fact, however, Santiago to Sydney flights go into the northern hemisphere, making stopovers at LAX and other North American airports, before continuing back down to the southern hemisphere. Such ridiculously wayward detours make no sense on the globe, but make perfect sense, and form nearly straight lines when shown on a flat Earth map.
So basically that was Eric DeBay with his bullshit that evidently some people suck in for. Indeed, I was at a talk by James Gilliland lately, and there was a woman there here in Australia actually saying that these various flights don't exist direct to South America and all the rest of it. It's just unbelievable that these people don't have any connection and all the rest of it. And they go on about, and she actually mentioned NASA. Well, NASA tells us the sky is blue. Oh, fancy that. Oh, shock horror. So anyway, yesterday I was in the Auckland airport, and it was the 20th of February 2016. And I looked up on the flight board and I could see my flight. So in this shot you can see, now I took EK413, the Emirates flight. And below it here you can see the LAN or LAN Airlines there, and they had the LA800 trip. Now that trip is a code shared trip, so various other airlines utilize it also. So you will see their names come up at, with that same flight. Both flights left at about the same time, so it would make sense. As I went around to my flight, and you can see the Emirates flight right here, you can see the LAN flight in the background there, LAN Airlines. And basically, they would have left, you know, about the same time. And this was at Auckland Airport, and indeed I have family and friends who have gone straight from Auckland Airport directly across to South America. We'll listen to some more bullshit now from Eric DeBay.
45. On a ball Earth, Johannesburg, South Africa to Perth, Australia should be a straight shot over the Indian Ocean, with convenient refueling possibilities on Mauritius or Madagascar. In actual practice, however, most Johannesburg to Perth flights curiously stop over either in Dubai, Hong Kong, or Malaysia, all of which make no sense on the ball, but are completely understandable when mapped on a flat Earth.
So coming out of that further bullshit, a friend of mine takes flights to Johannesburg from Sydney these days. I think it used to be from Sydney to Perth and then across to Johannesburg, but these days there are direct flights from Sydney to Johannesburg, and he takes these. So we'll listen to that recording right now. Yeah, Sid, so you fly from Sydney to South Africa. How do you do that?
Yes, I fly direct.
You fly direct?
From Sydney to Johannesburg.
And it takes, what, 12, how long? How many hours does it take?
Oh, 16, about 16.
Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. You used to fly from Sydney to Perth and then over to Johannesburg?
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, all right. All right, cheers, Sid.